Hello, welcome to this video. My name is Marco Nuyen and I'm a trainer at Microsoft. This video is part of a series of videos about the role of a Microsoft Cybersecurity Architect. Discover what it takes to become a Microsoft Cybersecurity Architect as we explore the role, key focus areas and top strategies to jumpstart your certification journey. In this video, we will look at the role and the certification Microsoft Cybersecurity Architect. In this video, I want to help you with a couple of aspects. What is the role of a cybersecurity architect? What are the areas to focus on? And how can you prepare? The Cybersecurity Architect video series is all about the aspects that come with the role of a cybersecurity architect. Let us start with the role first. What is expected? For that, you should always go to the certification page to read what the role is about. I've included a short link in the presentation that can help you easily find the certification page. There will be a lot of links like this throughout the entire video series. It makes it easier, hopefully, for you to further investigate a topic. What we see is a screenshot of the job task statement as found on the certification page. It sums up what is expected from a Microsoft Security Architect. What is it that you do as a cybersecurity architect? Well, you translate a cybersecurity strategy into capabilities that protect the assets, business and operations of an organization. You design, guide the implementation of and maintain security solutions that follow zero trust principles and best practices. And that will include working with a lot of other professionals at different levels in an organization. And you also need to ensure compliance. Operations and the general security posture are catered for. It's quite a broad task, and I do not expect that to change anytime soon. But do make sure you check the task every now and then, since we calibrate it regularly. It gets calibrated about once a year by a team from Microsoft and customer representatives. Audiences and needs. Security is a team sport, and for securing, we need to work with a lot of people in different roles. We will engage with a lot of different audiences and stakeholders, and every audience has their own needs. For our tasks as a cybersecurity architect, we are a bit in the middle of this graphic. Our strongest effort lies with architecture and policy, but we are involved in all other aspects. We work with the business and senior leadership on the vision and translate that. And we work with the implementation and operations to ensure things get deployed, managed and maintained. The graphic used is from the Microsoft Cybersecurity Reference Architectures, or MCRA, which we will discuss in one of the videos in the series. And it is graphics like this that will help you to understand or maybe even explain the role. Graphics from the MCRA and from other places. But let's us look at other main areas of attention. Areas of attention? Well, the certification, course and videos are organized around four main areas of expertise that we expect from a Microsoft Cybersecurity Architect. And these areas are security best practices and priorities, security operations, identity and compliance, solutions for infrastructure, and solutions for applications and data. We will have videos on topics within each of these areas. As you can imagine, these areas are not strict boundaries. The first one listed is about best practices. They will be relevant always and everywhere. So we will see them back again and again and again. But in the video series, I have reduced the amount of overlap. And the videos will not only cover some aspects of a topic, you will need to identify and research the parts that you are not familiar with by yourselves, conceptually and technically. The concepts and frameworks that align with security best practices and priorities are fundamental. And the most fundamental concept here is zero trust. Now, zero trust is a concept that goes back years and years, and it's the foundation under all our efforts on security. It helps to organize elements so they can be addressed properly. We will not discuss zero trust in length here. That is for another video, but I want to bring it to your attention here. Essentially, we are thinking of seven categories, six pillars plus another category that need to be addressed in our architectures. And maybe you're expecting the graphic and you see six. So what's the seventh? Well, it's the thing that brings everything together. It's the visibility, automation, and orchestration. And a task for us is to ensure everything in an organization becomes visible and cross-correlated. And we can use Zero Trust as a guiding framework for that. Above these pillars, there will be well, also other things like principles, three of them. But again, we will have many videos that will assess your further learning. Now, how to prepare for the exam? How to prepare? Start with the exam page, as is shown again on my screen. That's the starting point. You'll find all relevant information there, and it will be up to date. Explore the tips you will find on the exam page. There's a study guide that will explain in detail what you're expected to know. Use this video series I have recorded for you, but also use other resources like the pages to content on Microsoft Learn to prepare yourselves, and the short links I share with you in the videos in this series. The exam prep videos are also available, and they are short recaps per focus area to help you prepare for the exam. And if you want to see what an exam UI will look like, then explore the sandbox. Look at the sandbox, because the exam interface may have changed since you last saw it, if you've ever seen it before. And there was, for example, a major change to the interface early 2024. And if you have never seen it, well, it will help you to get more comfortable with the exam experience. Maybe reduce your stress a little bit by knowing what you're getting into. In the exam guide, you'll also find a lot of links to more information on the exam process and what kind of questions you can expect, or how to keep your certification alive by doing renewals, and much more. So go and enjoy the exam guide later. Another element you'll find in the exam page is a set of free practice assessment questions. Use them to verify what you've learned and use them to understand where you need to invest more time to learn. As you can see, they are without charge. The exam itself, however, will require a contribution from your side. This brings us to the end of this video. We looked briefly at the role of a cybersecurity architect, explored the focus areas, and discussed a couple of preparation resources. Thank you for watching. But that's not all. There is more, and there's always more. More questions and hopefully more answers, and more videos on the role of a Microsoft Cybersecurity Architect. Go find one, go enjoy, and please stay safe.